Armies throughout history have faced harsh weather conditions in various ways. The Army of the Potomac in the winter of 1862-63 was no different. Remember to like and share this video and subscribe to this channel if you want to see more content like this. There's also a link over to our library channel where we will be releasing a more in-depth video on this subject later on this week. Except for a small shelter half, the man in the ranks was left mostly to fend for himself when the army settled into semi-permanent camps after the Battle of Fredericksburg in December of 1862. The typical first step was to dig into the ground. This provided both protection from the wind and insulation, and it also meant that less wood would be needed in construction. With over 100,000 men competing for the same resources, this was a major consideration. Logs would then be stacked around the freshly dug hole. The civilian skills of these citizen soldiers would begin to show at this point. Logs would be corner notched to secure each layer and close the gaps as much as possible. Fires would often be set in the hole to dry and bake the living area. The roof would be framed various ways. Saplings lashed together into an A-frame was one common method. Fireplaces were cut into one of the earth walls and built up using sticks and mud or stone depending on available resources. Once the roof was framed out, shelter halves would be buttoned together, draped over the frame, and secured with nails or rope. Gable ends and doorways were a challenge to the unskilled, but over the course of a few weeks, these rudimentary structures would be greatly improved. Bunks, shelves, mantels, and other finishing touches would be added as time and resources permitted. However, inevitably, when active campaigning began in the spring, these rustic homes would be left behind. Thank you for watching.